agree with that. So let's talk a little bit about masks. I know this is always a fun topic, and we'll try not to get too political with masks, but I mean, the reason why I think it's important to talk about it is because Uber and Lyft have a policy that require drivers and riders to wear masks. So whether you agree with masks or not, that's the policy. It is what it is. You know, they're private companies. So if you want to work for them, you kind of have to do what they say. So here's how I will plan on handling, you know, so if I'm, you know, like I said, you know, I don't plan on driving right now where, you know, and I think a lot of other drivers, if there's issues with coronavirus, you know, once those start to dissipate and, you know, as drivers start to get back on the road, I think how I would handle the mask situation is very similar to how I handle other situations, right? It's all about diffusing kind of sticky situations, right? So, you know, passenger gets into your car with a bottle of alcohol, you know, a minor comes up and asks for a ride. I think these are actually two specific situations that we cover in the course, if I'm not mistaken. But, you know, some drivers to me, you know, tell me like, oh, I just tell them like, you know, basically go F yourselves. I'm not going to give you a ride. And to me, I think that the strategy, whenever you kind of encounter an unruly passenger, you always want to start with trying to diffuse the situation, because the reason is that, like, you know, you actually want to give these rides. You want passengers who comply, because it's going to make you more money. It's going to allow you to do more trips per hour, right? If you have to cancel on a person, you may or may not get that cancellation fee, but ultimately you're probably going to make more than the $3.80 you get from a cancellation fee after Uber and Lyft's fee by actually giving the ride, right? So I think generally you actually always want to do the ride. And how I would handle the mask situation is, first of all, you know, I think that it's important to tell people, hey, you know, the masks are for, you know, your safety and mine. You know, this is actually, you know, you can also sort of, sometimes I like kind of blaming it on Uber and Lyft in a way, say, hey, this is company policy. You know, they require both drivers, both riders to wear it. And unfortunately, you know, if I give you a ride and you're not wearing a mask, I could actually be deactivated from the platform. So now you sort of, you know, it becomes more, you know, like I think some riders may not want to wear a mask because they feel it's a personal issue. But if you turn it into an issue that now affects you, you know, beyond the health and safety, you know, instead of arguing with them whether it's safe or not, you can say, hey, I could actually get fired from Uber from doing this, you know, whether that's true or not, who cares? but, you know, you're, again, you're trying to diffuse the situation with the passenger. And then the other trick that I would, that I think is just a no-brainer, is I think everyone should have 3 or 4 cheap medical masks in their car for any passengers who come up. Maybe they forgot a mask, right? Maybe they just, you know, maybe they just didn't have one on that day and they just need you, you know, and like, you know, you could obviously cancel on them and not give them that ride. But if you actually want to give that ride, it doesn't cost you much to give them a 25-cent mask. You're not going to have to do it for every single passenger. So that's sort of how I would handle that. I like Jonathan's comment here. He says, masks, seatbelts, alcohol, it's all the same. Respectfully let them know before we get going. Yeah, so I think respect, but also, you know, understand, right? Like, I think we have a good article that we've written in the past. It's called, like, you want to be the captain of your ship. You don't want people to come in and push you around, but you want to be respectful. You want to be somewhat forceful. So yeah, that's how I would handle that. Melody says, Harry, you shouldn't drive. You have a new baby at home. Yeah, I mean, I think we're all going to have to kind of like, I haven't really thought about, you know, when I would do my next Uber trip, but I think that's something we're all thinking about. And that's one thing, you know, like right now, cases in California are spiking. And, you know, I think right now, more than anything, there's just a lot of uncertainty. So, you know, especially with a new baby in the house, I'd, you know, personally, like, rather not put myself or my family, you know, at risk. You know, how small or how great, it's hard to say. You know, I know Jay is living with his elderly mother right now and taking care of her. What a great son. Nice work, Jay. And, you know, he doesn't want to get her sick or, you know, get her, you know, kind of compromise her in any way. So he's sort of doing the safe thing there. So that's what I would say there. Melody says, good idea about the extra mask. You know, I think for me, it's always about like thinking about like, where can I get like a high ROI, right? Like, I'm not going to go give every passenger a mask, but I'm going to spend $5 on a box of masks so that if someone comes and they don't have a mask, maybe they just forgot it, right? Or maybe you say, hey, you know, I can't give you a ride unless you wear a mask. Would you like a free one? You know, and they give it to you and they give you an extra trip tip and it makes up for it right there. So that's how I would handle that. David says, no, riders don't give a damn. They'd rather give you a negative feedback. I mean, you know, I know obviously we've all had the like shitty riders who no matter what you do or no matter what you say, they're going to give you a bad rating. But I also like to weed those. Like, you can often tell like those guys from the beginning, right? And so if you're someone who really cares, you know, about your rating or you're sort of now hovering and bordering a 4.7, 4.6, you might want to be more careful and not even, you know, take someone like that from the first place. But, you know, if you're getting a low rating here and there, I don't think it's too big of a deal. say. Bernadine says, Lyft here in Austin, Texas requires a driver and passengers wear a mask and ride with windows down and not using circulating air on your AC. So I know that masks are a requirement for drivers and passengers, I believe, by both Uber and Lyft in every state. I'd be surprised if they made you ride with windows down. I think it's more of like, you know, suggested. I imagine, you know, if you're in Phoenix or Texas, where maybe this week or coming up shortly, it's going to be over 100 degrees, you know, riding with the windows down is not the best idea. You know, because it's so damn hot, right? That sort of might make you pretty uncomfortable. So I personally really like the N95 mask, you know, which was sort of at first they were kind of, you know, in very, very short supply. So they were only reserved for medical workers, but now they're a lot easier to find. And so you guys can go on Amazon or other sources. You know, people are now selling N95 masks. I've tried a couple. Just make sure you get one. Like the first one I tried was like a little tight on my ears. Then I tried another brand and it fit well. So the nice thing about the N95s, it sort of prevents you from spreading germs to other people, and it also prevents other germs from spreading to you, whereas the medical masks are sort of more for preventing you from spreading germs to other people. So Ruta says it's purely a health issue. Jay says the point is to get the air circulating so the virus can't land. Yeah, no, I totally understand the point of keeping the windows down and not doing recirculating air. I'm just saying if it's 110 degrees where you're driving, I don't know how feasible that solution is. Steven says, Tokta is an excellent mask. This sounds good. We're actually going to be reviewing a bunch of masks. So if you guys have masks that you like or that are a good deal or anything like that, feel free to shoot me an email, harry@therideshareguy.com. And just let me know what kind of mask you're using, what brand, you know, maybe I'll probably even go out and buy. I've been buying a bunch just to try them out. Jay says, just crack the window a bit. Yes, this is why Jay is, you know, one of our rideshare experts, because he's a little smarter than I am, right? I'm thinking here, like, roll the window all the way down. But yeah, I think you can kind of get some of the benefits by just cracking the windows, even if you're in a hot place. So Papa Smurf says no mask, no ride. And, you know, I haven't seen, you know, I think a lot of drivers, frankly, aren't driving right now. But I think as drivers start to get back on the road, I think there's going to be a lot of issues with, you know, mask enforcement. So I'm curious to know what you guys, if you guys have experienced this yet, what you're thinking, how are you going to handle, you know, a passenger, for example, that comes in and doesn't have a mask, refuses to wear a mask. I definitely have some ideas of my own, but I'd be curious to know what you guys say. Abstract says, I have a handmade mask. It's very comfortable. Yeah, I like the hand, you know, the handmade masks are obviously nice because you can kind of customize it to your face and, you know, do all that. DJ says, oh, and this is funny. Gabe says, but what if the passenger's toupee might fly out the window? So I guess, you know, like I said, maybe don't roll the window all the way down, just crack it. And then I guess the other thing, you know, I think most people know this, but, you know, there's usually a setting in your car where you can kind of do recirculated air or fresh air from the outside. And, you know, obviously in this case, you don't want to be recirculating air. You sort of want that fresh air. Let's see. So I see non-disposable masks need to be washed every day. Yeah, there's a lot of good info on masks. I appreciate you guys all sharing this. That's a good point, right? If you have one of those cloth masks, you know, you kind of imagine throughout the day you're accumulating a bunch of germs. So it makes sense. You probably want to go ahead and wash them. Jay says there's a video.